And oh no, we're chained up. Oh no, oh no. Yes, we killed them both, even though we were staked to the ground. How's it going, guys? John here from the Killer Bits, and welcome to the arena as we play Domina. Yes, we get to run our own gladiatorial school in this... Well, it's a management game, really, from the guys at Dolphin Barn. This game isn't actually out yet. It comes out on the 3rd of April, and so far I've sunk a ton of time into this. I've not really got very far, because there's a lot of different stuff you need to get your head around, and so far I've not beat any of the champions, so that's causing me issues. So I thought I'd do a fresh start and show you guys. Before we go into it, I just want to show you the options. As you can see, smack bang in the middle there. Yes, it has got Twitch integration, in fact, and it's something I might actually try giving a go using Twitch and see how that is. Game options, we're on mild at the moment, which I'm guessing is... Oh no, it's slightly lower than normal. Okay, well, do try normal. Because I was finding the mid game was a little easy. The early game gets a bit frantic, and then the late game, you're obviously trying to beat champions and that, but we'll try this. But we will go into a new game, and I will use the kind of tutorial screen to give you an idea of what the story is and how the different mechanics work. Not that there's that many mechanics, it's a basic management sim, so it's a lot of kind of micromanaging your people and building up kind of units and resources and things like that. But the sun is setting on the once mighty Roman Empire. Violent rebellion erupts in the far territories while political corruption erodes the empire closer to home. Fearing that the citizens will revolt and attempt to re-establish the Republic, the Emperor has decreed that there shall be a year of epic gladiatorial games, culminating in the greatest championship the Empire has ever seen, affording unimaginable reward of coin and glory. The Emperor hopes to revitalize commerce and establish the rule of law once again, but Rome is disintegrating in his clenched fist. The next local games are scheduled soon, and you aim to participate. So as I say, we'll do the tutorial and I can get into the different stuff. As the heiress to the once mighty Ludus in the heart of Roman countryside, you see an opportunity to ride this wave of revitalized interest in bloodshed to the ends of the empire, to burn out a fabulous spectacle of violence and greed. Having driven your family's Ludus into the ground with poor business decisions and lack of integrity, your father bequeaths to you ownership of the Ludus and the poultry holdings. On the dusty road home to assume the mantle of Lannister and Domina, a woman looks at you knowingly and proclaims, "They'll never let you win." You try to put the old woman's icy stare out of your mind as your family begrudgingly surveys their new home and your father slowly fades towards his inevitable death. So yes, we get to play as the Domina here, the mistress of this gladiatorial school. And we'll get the gladiators in training. This guy, we will... 128. I'd rather actually sell you. Yeah, we'll sell you. Just get training straight away. And we can tweak their stats. So agility, weapons, I'm going to push them up. And a bit of strength, say. And he's got a wooden gladius and he's got a bunch of armor. We can just swap this out. As you can see, left click downgrades it, right click upgrades it. He's got a big shield, wooden gladius. We'll give him a proper gladius and that costs us some money. And our other guy has got a basic pugia. We'll give him a wooden one. And again, try and push everything into agility. We want to be fast and stabbing hard. Go on, train, work for it. A large man with a whip has presented himself at your villa and requests your ear. I see that there are games scheduled in a few days and I've heard that you plan to attend. I served your father for many years, but when he fell ill and the Ludus turned to ruin, I had to find my daily bread elsewhere. I would be honoured to return to the Ludus and train your men for this battle. Without me, these men will slow and stupid lambs to the slaughter. So this is our trainer, and we'll get him to work straight away. We can enable automatic gladiatorial training. So it basically means everybody in the arena, well, not the arena, the training grounds here, will automatically start training up, which saves a bit of the micromanagement. And this is kind of the skill tree. So you can see here different stuff, rolling attack, blade control, things like that. But first thing on the tree is humility. Gladiator can surrender at any time during the battle, potentially saving his life. So yeah, we definitely want that. So these guys are training up. He's researching humility, and we've got one day until battle. There we go. So this being the kind of tutorial, it's fairly easy, this first guy, but we've only got two gladiators to choose from because we sold one, obviously. But I reckon we'll probably get away with using the weaker of the two. Obviously, this guy's got less health, but he's got the better armor and all that. And this guy's only got a wooden sword. But he's got 64 aggro, 73 turtle, which I'm guessing is the defense, and is 20 evasion. He's a bit more balanced. No, he's actually got more defense. Yeah, we'll definitely go with him. And he compares up to him about equal defense, less evasion, more aggression though. Agility 7, 8, 3, 1. We may lose this. Maybe we'll pick the other guy just in case. We don't want to lose the first battle because it's a shit ton of money and some wine and some slaves, so we can start training them up as well. So yeah, we should win this one, but you get to see the battle. It's all AI controlled. As we go up the skill tree, we can actually take control of one gladiator on the field, as that's one of the options. But for the most part, I tend to let the AI handle it because the fights are over that quickly. It's not so much about the fighting, it's more about training up, and it's a management game. So as you can see here, we get a bunch of gold, some wine, and four new slaves for the ludus. So we get to see them. So he's 153 health. Well, we need single blade ones because we need to research these guys first. The basically dual wielder, and then the typical kind of net and trident type guy. But once again, now we also have the option of meditate as well. Provides greater AI attack efficiency. So yeah, we'll bunch up that. We'll, as I say, I tend to let the AI handle most of it. And as I said, we want a lot of agility and weapons. And as I say, we'll train him up. So we get to start equipping these guys. We'll just stick all the kind of basic kit on them. We'll give them a shield. Right, that's it. You didn't fight, but you did. So you need healing up. So we'll do that, and he's won one battle. So to make him feel good about it, oh, he's agreeable at the moment. If you reward them coin or wine, they become more agreeable. Okay, next guy. Ooh, 173 health. So yes, definitely get him training up. Agility, weapons, and a bit of strength. Yeah, we'll go a lot of strength with him. He's got the health, so he can be a bit more of a tank. So bunch up the defense. There we go. Say something like that. Knock down the agility, defense. There's no real indicator of how much effect you're having on that, but it makes me feel better about myself. We'll give him a skirt. There you go. Next one, 164. So yeah, once again, we'll do the same. Basic weapon, basic gear. And the last one, 155. Not that much. Okay, I'm going to leave that guy. We can have him just training, essentially, but we won't actually set him as a class just yet. And here we go. New member has joined the villa. An old man enters the villa uninvited. He appears to be a highly placed government official. He introduces himself. I am the magistrate. I was impressed with your showing in my games yesterday. Your prowess as a Lannister is evident, though you may be lacking in experience. Your father was a good man, and I'm sorry to see his business and health failing. If you are in search of a new slaves to turn into gladiators, I can provide you with agreeable stock. The smell of wine on this dusty old fuck's breath is off-putting. So basically, he's a bit of a slave merchant, but we're all right for slaves at the moment. But we also have the marketplace here. We've got a lot of coin, so we might as well buy a bit of extra food and water, because as you'd imagine, the more people we have here, the more they're going to get through it. And I'm also going to start stacking these guys up in the order I want them, because something else you can get in the marketplace is actual employees, and we'll get into that in a minute. So what's this guy? He's got a basic pugia, so it's just like basically the knife, and he's AI skill 6, not a lot of aggression, a lot of turtling, so he's going to be very defensive, and not a lot of evasion. So I reckon we should be alright with the second guy here. Or in fact, we could just, let's just throw in him. This is going to be cruel and unusual punishment. He has no weapons, he's completely unarmed, but you get to see what happens when you do that. So occasionally the obviously he's going to turn tail and run in 4, 3, 2, 1, but he's going to take a hit and he's going to run away. A gift from the crowd. See, the crowd have thrown in a couple of blades, and there we go. As I say, it is the tutorial, so it's pretty much geared towards you winning, and he got a lot of kind of buffs from that, and he's obviously got a couple of weapons as well, and we've got a shit ton more money and a load more slaves. So where's my two knife guy? Heavily armed soldier barges into the ludus unannounced. His armor is adorned with fine detail, and you gather that he is an important person by the way he strikes fear into your slaves. I'm Legati, the commander of the military detachment stationed nearby. I was impressed with your showing at my games yesterday, but if you want to win more bouts in the arena, you'll need better trained warriors, and I have many to spare. My warriors may not be agreeable and cheap as the magistrate's useless wares, but at least they know how to wield a sword. The man demands wine as he reclines on your balcony. So these guys, you can actually bribe them. You can get them to, you know, purchase slaves and gladiators from them, arrange exhibition matches, and you can eventually get them to be patrons of individual gladiators, basically paying for all their stuff, as you can see in the tooltip there. As a patron, the Legati will assume all day-to-day costs for your selected gladiator, basically until they die. But we've got the marketplace now here. Right, straight away, I want to buy some employees. Now, as you can see, all these guys have different costs to them. You know, Bard is 13 coins, but a Secretus costs 100. But he consumes nothing, whereas most of these guys will be consuming water and food every day. But one thing I want to get straight away is the architect, because as you can see here, build stationary additions to your ludus for comfort and profit. Upgrade stay even if he leaves. So we're definitely going to hire him. And I also want, shall I get the medic straight away? Yeah, the medic's useful early on because everybody's going to get injured, definitely. But we have other ones like the Educator, which will... Educator helps turn your gladiators into self-actualized men with the function of peak performance at all times. And he helps the AI proficiency, reduces costs of upgrades and resources, sacrifice to the gods, all this kind of thing. Provides you with 4 food a day. That could be useful. Food goes down quite quickly, especially when you've got a full school of gladiators going on. But I think... Who have we got at the moment? We've just got the... So we've got the medic and the architect. Architect, I want to get going straight away. I want to build some training dummies. And you can go there. And we can stack all these guys up. Oh no, you've got a shield. Right. Who's this? So he's got a wooden trident. So he's the net and trident guy. He's AI skill 33, aggression 99. Now this may be one we actually refuse. Agility 4, level 1. How's our best gladiators? Turtling, aggression. Actually, I'm going to reject the terms of this. And that actually affects these guys, because these guys put on the fights. But rather than losing one, I'll training dummy's ready, so he's already training with that. So we'll get the next one up. And who was injured? Somebody was injured. But this guy should automatically heal if we turn that on. And you should be training. We'll do nimble stance. And water, we'll grab a bit of water. Now, one thing we can also do is attend pit fights. These are, for a small fee, you can challenge one of the gladiators in a prize fight. For the cost of one coin, I think it's worth trying. But no. We can put in four fighters, but against four this early on, I really don't want to lose, basically, you know, four people we've got trained up already. That might be a bit of a tough one, so I'm going to reject the terms for that. So we've only lost one coin, though. We haven't lost any standing with the magistrate and things like that. And everyone's working on it. Right. Somebody was showing up in the loadout screen as hurt, but I think this may be because it's beta. Won one battle. Who's the other one that's won a battle? Has won one battle. Ah, right. Okay. Well, he's worth training up then now. He's got 10 meditate, so he's got 10 AI control. We'll go agility and weapons again. Yeah, might as well. And we'll give you all the basic kit again. There we go. Right. And we'll give him a gold coin, and he'll be pleased with that. We can also, we've got a bit of wine, and I think this affects health as well. No, it hasn't affected that. Sometimes it affects health or the points here. Not quite sure what these points are. I'm presuming these are agility and weapons and defense, yeah. Okay, right. Moving on. So we've got 2 days until the next fight. Build another one. As I say, if we can get this top row all kitted out with these training dummies, at least they're going to be speeding up their training. Right, pick gladiator. Who will we go with? We will go with, what was his? He was level 1, level 4 attack, AI. So he's quite quick. He's not had any victories yet, but he's got a lot of health. Jupiter's Blessing, Indefatigable, level 2. I'm going to risk... He's quite evasive, so yeah, we'll try him. He's not had any victories yet, no, he's just a basic guy. So if we lose him, we're not losing too much. I know one of these early fights, you're pretty much guaranteed to lose. Let's go. Go on. Yeah, he's getting all the quick early hits in. You can see our health there. Yeah, we're going to lose this. But can we... Do we surrender or do we... No, we're dead. So sometimes when you take a defeat, you can surrender. As you can remember, that was one of the early options on the training. Yes, keep going with the training. Oh, your father calls to you. You show great promise as a Lannister. You are a natural. No doubt you seek glory in Rome. In order to qualify for the great championship games, you will need to win some regional championships. This map shows the local heroes, some of them massive behemoths, for each region. I've estimated the cost of attending each of these games, but be aware that while the rewards are handsome, it will cost a great deal of resources to travel to these games. When you have achieved a victory in the regional championships, you will tell... I will tell you of Jupiter's Blessing. So these are regional games. So far, I think I've seen that one. Brave Warriors, Fabled. No, I think these change out a little. But essentially, you can see there it's going to cost 2 gold, 13 days to get there, 4 food and 10 water. But these guys are incredibly tough. I mean, you know, like, you know, 400 to 500 health points. You're normally sending like 3 against 1, so that, and they all get slaughtered in the first 3 seconds. So it's one of those. You should be building stuff. Build another Paulus. Does anybody need healing up? You should be auto-healing, but we can also get you to start studying these, which will help increase treatment speed. So 15 gold, but 6 days, yes. And we need to keep an eye on our supplies. So yes, we'll grab some water and grab some food. And I think we'll hire another person. I've tended to go with the blacksmith because he can automatically upgrade stuff. There we go. Inexpensive upgrades and equipment repairs. A favor automatically repairs damaged equipment and makes upgrades cheaper. I'm wondering if there might be a better choice. I mean, this guy is really expensive. He's 100 coin. I mean, not that we're hurting for cash, but he consumes nothing, so we don't have to worry about our water or food. He never speaks, but appears to boost natural processes of those nearby. What is these strange lights? So he'll improve healing, training, and morale boost. Upgrades helping them level up and heal faster. I think we'll go with the blacksmith at least to start off with. Get those early upgrades if possible. And we'll get him to work. And automatic upgrades, yes. And also toggle on auto repair. Right. We've got dummies all across the top, so I think we'll work on hot coals for agility. And you're almost done. Oh, and sometimes you get these random events. So an aqueduct has collapsed in the city. Many homes are without water. The magistrate seeks help with the situation. Could be seeking help with sanitation. I don't know. What did the Romans ever do for us? Will you at least give 13 water to aid those who are without? So we could possibly do so, but we also have an architect. Offer your architect to help reconstruct the aqueduct. So we'll do that. Your architect design and handiwork is well received, and the aqueduct is repaired quickly and professionally. So it didn't cost us any water. There we go. Aimed attack is done. Right, we will study mind control. Allows you to directly control one gladiator on the battlefield. So I can show you what it's like. But as I said, I tend to just let the computer do it all. But we can also attend pit fight. So we've got a 0 victories and a 3 victories. As it says there, details are hazy in the low light of this dank pit. So we haven't got any details on what their stats are. So basically go into this blind. A victory will award us 122 gold, 35 water, and that's 2 strength on training. I'm tempted to risk one of our lesser guys. Then again, it's up against 2. What are these guys like? 10, 82, 11, 55. We want a quick person, really. If there's 2 of them, we want them to be quick and nimble. None of these are. Okay, I'm going to risk another one of the lesser guys. He'll probably die. Quite more than likely, yeah, because these guys aren't injured at all. So they're full strength. And it's one weak dude against 2 better armoured. Yep. Yeah, oh, he's doing some damage to that guy, but he's... Yep. He's down for the count, but do we get a defeat or... Yeah, he's a dead one. So I haven't shown you the surrendering yet. And he's still studying mind control, so we haven't got that yet. Let's get one guy in this position and get him training up as a... Who's he? What's it? Oh no, 154. We got a better health person. Yeah, we'll go with you. Same again. We could maybe give them slightly better kit, so they last a bit longer. So we'll give them a shoulder blade thing. And again, usual thing of weapons, agility. Yeah. And we'll make him happy by just giving him a coin. There you go. He's encouraged now. So we'll swap you with you. Oh, and this guy is a 1, agility 1, attack level 1. Yeah, so he's going to be relatively easy to defeat, theoretically. Well, we're sending the new guy. Send in the new guy. Go on. I'm going to get 115 coin out of this. Let's see how it goes. And we're making short work of him. And he's did. That's it, he's gone. We get our victory. Entry 15, got a couple of slaves, and there's our extra training. But he is injured now, so we are going to have to heal him up. And oh, you can be doing more hot coals. As I said, I want this top row completely done with the training stuff, so these guys actually start leveling up as quick as possible. And mind control is done, so next up I'm going to go this way on the path so we can get up to the Mamilla training. Actually, that is probably actually better, but that obviously takes longer. Stuff it, we'll go that way. And as I say, we need to keep our eye on our water and our food. Yeah, that should be alright for now. Right, you're studying that. Oh, you can be studying hand washing. 15 coin, but it's not going to cost us anything else. Yeah, there we go. Coal pit done. We'll do no coal pit then. And we can actually upgrade these, some of these guys, if we want. We can give him a gladius, say. And we could upgrade the shield. No, I don't want to upgrade the shield. But we can see he's starting to level up. We will give you some better mind control. Not mind control, the meditate for the AI control. I'll tweak those a little. Yeah, more strength. Less defense, more strength. Yeah. Fix captain's helmet, onyx pauldrons. So yeah, he's at work with the auto upgrades. Better tools, repair speed increased. I'm going to go with weapon blueprints. We'll keep an eye on those. Right, okay, what's this? So it's 2 against 2. He's agility level 1. AI skill 15. This should be a relatively easy fight. So I'm going to send in our best fighter and one of our weaker dudes. You've already got one victory. We'll do that one and that one. And we have control now. As you can see here, this one's AI, this one is controlled by me. We can toggle it on and off, like so. But we're controlling the weaker guy. We want the computer to keep him alive. Maybe we can do some damage with this guy. We'll find out. So, using Wazda, and you can see my sword icon, so let's go. And, oh no, we're chained up. Oh no. Yes, we killed them both, even though we were staked to the ground. So we should get some bonus crowd money. Yeah, there we go, crowd favour. So we've got a couple more slaves, and these guys did well. And I did well, impressively. I wasn't expecting that. So who's... Yeah, you. So we're definitely going to heal you up. And I'm going to reward you with some coin and some wine. And that boost points on the weapon, was it? Okay. And I'm going to give you a better sword. And we'll give you a leather cocksheath. No, we'll make it a studded one. There you go. You're our stud now. I'm hoping as the debate goes on and it gets developed, we can actually start renaming these. Because, I mean, the fact that this woman's called the Domina and that, all I think of is HBO's Rome. So I want a Titus Pullo and a Lucius Verinus in this. There was another one that was injured, wasn't it? Him, yes. Heal you up. You need to be building more coal pits. And food and water is going down, so we'll do that and that. We've got a lot of slaves, so it might be worth selling some of these. So we'd look for the lowest health ones. I normally flog them off. So, oh, 133. Yeah, well, we'll get 8 coin for you. There's a 155 as well, wasn't there? 159. 150. Yeah, we'll sell you as well. There we go. Right, so this is 3 victories. Ooh, he's agility level 7, level 8. This is going to be a definite loss. Oh, I really don't want to risk anyone. 122. No, no. I'd rather go to the pits. There we go. He's not very happy with us, but we can send him some wine. That should perk him up. And just to hedge your bets, we'll send you some wine as well. You're satisfied. There we go. Let's put 10 pit fights. 2 victories, basic Pugia. We'll pick a gladiator. Our best one, our second. Well, you haven't had any victories yet, but your reasonable agility and attack level. Not great AI. Is it worth me going in for the fight on this? Probably not. I'm going to leave the AI to do it. Oh, God. I'll make this the last fight of the video, and we'll see how I get on. I'm probably going to lose this guy. But maybe we'll get the chance to surrender. Ready in 4, 3, 2, 1, fight! Did we win? I think we won. Victory! So we got a couple of good hits in. We didn't get any bonus money from the crowd, but you don't tend to in the pit fight. But we got a couple more slaves, which we can flog. And we've got some coin. So, what are these? 145, yeah, we'll sell you. And 153, yeah, we'll sell you as well. It's just more mouths to feed. Now, a small auction in the city, you spot a slave girl, red of hair, knowing that both the magistrate and the legate favour such women. You purchase her for a good price. Keep her for your own house. She's sure put envy into both selfish, creepy old bastards. Offer the girl to stuff them both. I'm going to keep her. She's mine. So yeah, both have gone down, but we were going to lose one anyway. We'll keep topping this lot up. And on that note, as I said, this is Domina. I'm going to probably carry on playing this, so I might turn this into a mini Let's Play series. See if we can make it through all 365 days. We've only done, 1 month, 2 months so far? Well, 2 days to the next fight. We'll make the next fight the last fight. And is it worth attending a pit fight? See if we can get a bit more cash? What the hell? No. I'm going to save my fighters for the big event. There we go. And net defense. Yes, we'll do that. Getting everyone working. Do we need a... Yeah, we need cot calls for you. You can start studying. 15 days, 18 days, 50. Study antiseptics for us. There you go. And you're done studying weapon blueprints. Well, study armor blueprints then now. So here we go, final battle. Victory's 5. Ooh. Agility level 1, attack level 5. He's fairly balanced. More aggressive, more defensive than evasive. So ideally we could do with a quick guy. So you're 39, 20, 55. You've got one victory so far. 73, not very defensive, but he's 8 and 7. Go on, we're going to throw you into the fight. Let's see how he fares. And as I say, this will be our... Oh, am I in control? Yes, I'm in control. Oh, I forgot to turn it off AI. Are we doing much damage? I can't tell. Oh, yes, we just get it in the end. So there we go. Victory is ours. And this, as I said, has been Domina. Out on the 3rd of April. And I think it's going to be about $10. And from what I've played so far, it's definitely worth picking up if you like these kind of management type games. There's a bit of action in it. Obviously, you can control the fighters yourself. But it's mostly a management game. And we could tweak this out if we wanted. I have had some fairly... spectacular kind of bugs in the arena so far. I mean, if you go over to our Twitter @thekillabits, you'll be able to see that. But yeah, if you enjoyed this, Well, if you want to check out the game, I will leave a link in the description below so you can find out more information. And if you enjoyed the video, hit that like button. And if you want to see more, as I said, I may well continue this as a series. So why not hit that subscribe button? And if you want to get in touch in the comments below or on any of the socials over at The Killer Bits. All right, until next time, guys. Catch you later.